Welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we are going to generate signature and place into a PDF. I have made a similar video, which was one of my first video where I generated a signature and placed it into a PDF. But the method that I used there was a HTML file. So here I am going to use an Word template where you can place this signature and whatever value that you want to send. So first of all, go to input for pen input. Then now I need to get data from this input and place it into a variable. So I'll use a button for that. So I'll set a variable. So in the pen input, I am going to take the base 64 value from the signature I do here. So go to button, take out the base 64 value. For that, I will use JSON to extract the base 64 value from the image. So pen input to dot image include. So let's see what this gives. So I'll put HTML label just to check what value it's giving. So let's go to text, put a HTML value. It is just to show you what value this variable is taking. So I'll just copy this and put in the HTML value of this one. So now let's do a signature here. Okay, so this is the base 64 value that is generated from the signature. And now, with this base 64 value, I don't need so the first 24 character here is defining us the format of this image, which we don't need. You just need to start from here. So what I'm going to do is, if I put something like mid and then starting off 24 and then length of if I do this, what it's doing is it's starting from after 24 characters and ending it. I am going to set this value and send it to a flow to generate the signature and store it in OneDrive. So let's just control J then. Let's just keep it as it is. Until then, I'll create a flow. So go to actions, click on Power Automate, and create a new flow. So you can start from any of the template, but we can just start from scratch. So you can skip this. So name this flow, let's call it generate letter from PowerApp. Search for PowerApp and put some steps. So first step would be creating a signature. So create file, and over here. We were going to define the folder this file will be stored into. So I have this demo folder here, and I'll call it signature dot we can put jpeg, and then we can get the content of the file in PowerApps. So I'll ask in PowerApps for the content, but what we need to do as well is we need to convert this content that we get from PowerApps into a binary format. So this is in base64. I need to convert it to binary. So I'll go to expressions. What I just did was, so over here I copied this. So when you copy this and you paste it over here, you get the code that is generating automatically. So this is the code that we need, and we want to place it within our conversion expression. So base64 to binary, this is what we need, and I am pasting these values. So it starts like base64 to binary, and from this trigger we are getting this create file content, which we are getting for PowerApps, and then done. So let's save this. Next thing we need to do is get the content of this signature. So I'll do get file content. So I'll get the signature content, and for that I need to know the unique identifier of the file, which I can easily get from here, which is the identifier of this file. And the next thing I need to do is populate my Word document template. So the action is populate, and this is the Word document that we want to populate. And I have already created a Word document and saved it in my OneDrive, which is somewhere over here. And in this Word document, we need to create a template. Now we can do that is we need to create a template, and then the values, when we need the values to be filled, we can go to developer and add these fields there, something like this or this, or if you want to add image, we have an option like this. You might not have this developer option on, and for that you can go to file, you can go to you might not have this option there, so you can go to file, click on options, and then click on customize ribbons, and then you can turn on this developer option. So now let's go over here, let's select the file, select this OneDrive for Business, and select for our document library, which is OneDrive, then search for the file, which is over demo folder, and this is my template file. And in this template I have two places where I can fill in data, which is over here and here. So here I can it's a place where I put text. So for the text I can again ask in PowerApps. So I get text from the PowerApps, and over here I need to fill in the values of the file content, which I can get from here. So file content. So next thing we do is from this Word template, we need to convert this Word into a PDF. So what we can do is I can first create a Word file, and define a path, which is in demo folder. For now you can place it wherever you want. Then you can put something like test, see. Then you can get a file content, which is this one, and then we want to convert this Word into a PDF. So convert file using path, and the path, we have it here, and file is PDF. Now the conversion is done. We need to create a file. And get the unique identifier of this file. First we need to define path, which is again in the demo folder. We can call it my letter.pdf and get the file content from just above. We can respond this back to PowerApps to have it displayed in PowerApps PDF viewer. So let's search for respond and create an output, which is a file. Let's call it file. Enter a value. So we need content from here. So let's put we can do this, or we can also take file from here, but I think this should be fine. So let's save this. Let's come back here. We are over here. So this is the one that we just created. So let's get it into our button. So I'll just cut it because my previous code is gone. So I'll just cut it and control Z it. Or I can just rewrite whatever I have written. So set. The response that I get it from here, I'll put it under another set view PDF separate by and I need to pass the value of var pin, which is the first one, and then I also need to pass the value of person who this certificate belongs to, which will appear somewhere here. So I can put a text fetch the value of this text. I think we are good. So I also want to navigate it to the next screen where this value would be shown, and I think we have something called PDF. Sorry, PDF viewer here, which is here, and I need to get the value that I get from here, and put it here, and this is what I get because we are sending file. So let's come back here, put my name here, click this button, should have put navigate for me to transition it to next, which I didn't do, I guess. So the problem here is I forget to put this over here, and now let's run it and let's put a navigate at the end as well. And let's put a navigate to screen 2. We need to fix when we are sending response to Power Apps. So we cannot just send this content. We need to bit of modify it so that we are just sending out the content, not the whole JSON body. We need to copy this here. So what we needed over here is we need to have just the content. So body, and then at the end we need content. Let's save this. So let's click this button. So here we go. So certificate of completion is generated for me. Let's check my folder. This is my letter that was generated. And this is the signature that was created. So that's it, guide. So hope you like this tutorial. If you want to see more videos like this, please put a comment on what you want to know, what you want to if you are struggling through something, please let me know. If you want more videos like this, please click please subscribe to my channel, and if you want to stay notified, click on the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching my video. See you next time.